the party. They eat fruit and cucumber. They fell in love.
Then what did
they say? Thank you. A big bang came and they died. Dinosaurs fell in love, but they didn't say goodbye. But they didn't say goodbye.
Hey guys, it's Brennan. It's so good to be with you guys today. I'm excited to talk with you guys about how to persevere well. And I think it comes so timely as we're walking through COVID-19. But also as you guys, there's always going to be hardships, guys. Hardships are going to be inevitable. The question shouldn't be how do we avoid hardship, but rather how do we walk through hardships and persevere well. So I'm going to share with you guys three practical things that has helped me in my journey as I walked through this season, but also during times where I had to walk through different seasons of hardships in my life. So the first point I want to share with you guys is taking the first step. God doesn't always give us the full picture, and sometimes we don't know why. And all we are given is just the next step that we have to take. And I think God does that for a number of reasons. Perhaps one of them is because he knows that we'd be feeling overwhelmed or even frightened if we see where we must go. Growing up, believe it or not, I was a super shy kid. I remember we had to do speeches for our English classes. And this was back when I was in grade 4 or 5, I believe. And I remember that I would deliberately fail the class speeches so that I won't be selected to move on to the all-school speeches, and oh my goodness, I would not even want to go to the provincial level. So if at that time God would have told me, hey, you're going to be talking with this youth virtually, or you're going to lead worship on Sunday mornings, I would have run for the hills. So I think God, knowing that I'd be afraid of where he was going to take me, he didn't show me that full picture. He just showed me the next step. Perhaps another reason why God doesn't always give us a full picture is because he wants us to focus on the here and now and not be so focused on the end goal that we miss out on the opportunity to learn and grow and even make awesome memories along the way. Maybe another reason why God doesn't always give us a big picture is that he wants us to trust him, that this is an opportunity for us to build our faith in him, for us to lean upon him and to trust that even though we don't know what the future holds, that we can trust in a God that has everything under control. Now, you might be having the question, okay, I'm not going to worry too much about the future right now. I'm going to focus on my next step. But what happens if I don't know what the next step looks like? And I mean, that's something that honestly I'm walking through right now. And one of the practical things that has been helping me kind of walk through the season of uncertainty is to take inventory and take stock of what God has given me in this season and power in the place that God has placed me. And I want to invite you to do the same. And practically what that has looked like for me is that I literally wrote down all the things that God has entrusted to me. And I've asked God, how can I serve you and honor you well in these areas? And I believe that as you honor God with the small things that he's placed in front of you, he's going to give you even greater things and going to entrust you with even more. So I want to invite you guys to continue to be faithful where you are right now, power in the place that he has placed you. Some of you may know what the next step is, but you're not unsure how to take that next step. Or maybe that next step, it feels like a very big leap for you. One practical thing that has helped me is, so I would open up my device, my iPad or my iPhone, and I would pull out my notes, and if I have a project that's just been lingering on my mind, I literally write the name of the project at the very top, and then I do what I like to call a digital vomit. I literally write everything about it, all my thoughts about it, what people have said about it, the people that needs to be involved to get this done, the outcomes that I need to see or the tangible things that might need to take place. I write it all down, put it on a piece of paper, and then I take some time to start organizing it, putting it in chronological order. And essentially what you will then have is a roadmap of how to get that step done. So with all that in mind, that first point that I want to leave with you guys on how to persevere well is to just focus on the next step. Don't feel so overwhelmed with the big picture right now. Just focus on the next step. The second point I have for you guys is push through in faith. And I have a story to go with that. So when I was growing up, I was a bit of a chunky kid. I mean, I was out of breath all the time. And I remember in grade 7 in my middle school years, we had to do what we call like an excursion every single month. So sometimes it was kayaking, sometimes it was biking, it was a hiking, snowshoeing. And I remember on this one trip, we had to go cave climbing. And I thought, oh, cave climbing would be like, you know, grab a little flashlight, you see the cute little bats along the way. We don't have those caves here, at least the ones that we went to were not like that. They were literally the size of my diameter and a little bit more, and you had to crawl through this little cave, and it wasn't even like just horizontal to the ground, it was vertical, so you're climbing up in this super tight, narrow space. And being a chunky kid, I was terrified, I was frightened. I remember I was brought to the opening of this cave, and you had to be hoisted up, and God bless the man who pulled me up and carried me through that. But I remember he lifted me up, he put me into this little hole, and it was pitch black dark, it was filled with fruit flies. It was not a pleasant experience, but I remember I was crawling in there, and I was like, okay, I'm doing this, I'm getting there. And I remember I turned the corner, and right in front of me was this gray mask. And I remember I could not see a thing, and it looked like I was being blocked completely. And I, at that point, started getting a little bit scared. I was like, okay, what do I do in this situation? And I had two options at that point. I could either look behind me and I had half the class behind me and just yell down the hole and ask them to backtrack, or I could push forward. And I knew that there were at least a couple guys in front of me. So I'm like, if they had got through, I mean, like, unless the cave had crashed or something, they would have got through. So I remember I pushed through, and what I found out, it wasn't actually a boulder. It was the guy in front of me had gray pants, and it was super dark, and I didn't see it, and I literally thought it was a wall. In my defense, all I had was those, you know, scholastic book fairs, those little flashlights that you can get from them, and I remember I was just shining my way through. Yeah. So why am I telling you this story? Perhaps today you are climbing through a tunnel, and you started it, it was a little bit tough, you took a couple steps, and you kind of got your pacing, you're making your way through, and then suddenly, you're up against a gray boulder. You're up against something that you feel so insurmountable that you can't get past it. And now you have to make a decision. Do you go back? Do you give up? Or do you push forward? And I want to invite you guys to push through in faith, because you have a God that is bigger than the circumstances that you are in here. You have a God that is bigger than that boulder that is in front of you. And I want to encourage you guys that we have access to God. God is not just far off in some distance. We have direct access to Him through prayer. And I know it sounds cliche, or pray about your problems, but it is so true. And I remember someone describing prayer to me in this way, as imagine being able to enter into a throne room of a king that is in complete control, and having access and laying your request before someone who can actually do something about your problem. And I want to invite you guys that even right now, like, if you have a problem that you're facing that feels insurmountable, pause this video and take some time to ask God to help you walk through that situation, to make it through the situation, because believe me, God is going to be fighting for you. This battle is the Lord's. It belongs to Him. He is in control, and He's going to fight for you. So as a quick summary, again, about how to persevere well. First one being focusing just on this next step. Don't worry too much about the big picture at this moment. Just take that next step. And the second one being push through in faith, and that you have a God that is so powerful and that has your back, and that you have direct access through in prayer. And the third point that I have for you is to ask yourself, what can I be learning in this season of persevering? Perhaps God is using this season of hardship to prepare you for something even bigger, something even greater, something even more exciting. So in this season, perhaps He is equipping you with the tools and the skills and the things that you need so that you'll be able to handle the next step. Maybe He is encouraging you in this season to turn to a parent, to turn to a friend, to turn to a youth leader or a pastor or someone in your life, and build around you a network of believers, because he knows that in this next season that he's going to take you, you're going to need prayer, and having this network around you is going to be helpful. So I want to invite you guys to ask yourself, what can I be learning, or who can I be connecting with, or how can I be growing in this season of waiting, on in this season of hardship and persevering? And believe me, God has something exciting for you. He's going to blow your mind. So get ready for that overflow in your life. So in conclusion, I hope that these 3 points will help you as you guys are walking through this difficult season of COVID, or if you guys are also facing other challenges in your life. The 3 points that that has helped me again is being just taking that first step in faith, not focusing so much on the big picture and getting lost in the end goal. Pushing through in faith, recognizing that we have a God that has our back, and we have access to a King through prayer that can change and affect our circumstances. And the third thing being is to think and ask ourselves, how can we be growing and learning in this situation? Who can I be surrounding myself in this situation? And looking forward to where God is going to take us next. So I want to leave you guys today with a verse, James 1 verses 2 to 3. And I hope that it encourages you guys. Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. So go forth in faith, guys. Believe that God has your back and He is in control of your situation. God bless you, and I'll see you again soon.